from television shows like Ray Donovan and Sons of Anarchy to movies like Wild and Lee Daniels' The Butler. Our next guest is the actor to watch.
And you can watch him on the second season of the TNT series Murder in the First, premiering June 8th. Mo McRae, welcome to Arise 360. How you doing?
Hey.
I'm great, thank you.
Good.
How are you?
Happy to have you here.
Yeah, so you got to tell us more about Murder in the First and your character, Sugar.
That's a good name.
Sugar Cascade, yeah. I was pretty pumped about the name. Murder in the First is set in San Francisco. It follows these homicide detectives. Each season, they kind of delve into one case. Mm-hmm. So it's not like the traditional format where, you know, by the end of the episode, they're going to have it all figured out. On this, they get to go deeper and find more twists and turns and character development along the way.
Now, your character's a gangster.
They're trying to figure it out. I think he has some gangster qualities.
Yeah, he's
when
like
convenient.
The unofficial mayor of the projects.
Exactly.
Yeah, okay.
Exactly. Oh, you've been doing your homework.
A little bit.
I know about Sugar Cascade.
So see? Speaking of homework, how did you prepare to play this character?
Well, that's a great question. I did a lot of things to prepare for this. I grew up in a pretty tough environment.
Okay. Mm.
So
where?
I grew up in South Central LA.
Oh.
Yeah,
pretty
I grew
tough,
up.
You said.
That was
yeah.
really tough.
When it was one of the most dangerous neighborhoods in the country when I grew up. Uh-huh. So a lot of my friends kind of remind me of this character, so I kind of get to pay homage to the neighborhood I grew up in and try to humanize them. Because I think the difficult thing with characters like this, people try to play all the bravado and play one note, but this guy, I feel like it's important for him to smile, be charismatic, have things that he cares about, things that he loves.
Yeah, well, make him a real person, a more nuanced
exactly,
character.
Exactly, dynamic as possible.
Yeah.
Right, let's take a look at your dynamic performance.
Yeah.
Don't want to tell me your name.
Because you already know it.
It's been a few years since we crossed in the cuts. Why I ain't lost track of you, English?
You know what? I got your whole resume on file. You sniper, Desert Storm.
Then you bounced into the blue at what? It was 22, right? Mm. You spent 2 years on the beat. Looking all clean, then you went straight in the gangs.
Then you got promoted after those heel stabbings and the homicide. I don't lose track of nobody, Inspector. I keep my eyes wide.
Don't blink.
I don't.
Confrontation, though.
I know, you've got my eyes wide. Scary, sinister.
Wow, that's kind of intense, right?
Yeah,
right.
Very subtle, but powerful.
Yeah. And we see Taye Diggs there, along with you co-star also with Kathleen Robertson. What are they like on set, and what's the energy like on the set?
Oh, they're great.
It's not always that intense?
No, it's funny. It's kind of like on my last show. You do this intense work on screen, and you cut, and you got Taye running around eating Skittles and singing and dancing. He's a character on set. Mm-hmm. Kathleen's a little bit more reserved, but Taye likes to put on the show in between takes.
Mm-hmm. A lot of the stuff is serious, so he likes to have a little fun. Is that what he's trying to break up?
I guess. You know, everybody has their own method.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, sure.
I'm like more of a method actor, so I don't really engage in his jokes.
So you dive in and become that character.
Yeah, I try to go in pretty deep.
Do you take the gangster home with you also?
No, I leave the gangster on set.
Okay, so just method while
you're
there.
In case somebody may request it.
You know, all right.
Wait a minute.
In case you got to handle some business.
Yeah, they might bring it out.
We have to talk about Sons of Anarchy also.
Okay.
That's one gritty show.
Yeah. It was all the grits there.
What's it like for you? What was it like for you to be a part of that ensemble?
It was really a blessing, that stage of my life and career to be a part of that, because some of those people had been there for 7 years. Mm-hmm. So you really, truly developed that familial vibe.
Yeah.
And someone like Charlie Hunnam, who was, he never dialed in a performance. Mm-hmm. Like to the every single episode, every scene, I could tell he was always well studied. Mm-hmm. He had ideas, choices. He was really dedicated and committed. So it taught me a lot getting to work with him, and we was able to develop a friendship out of it. Mm-hmm. So I think we approached the work similarly. Mm-hmm. He was like obsessive about it.
Mm-hmm.
And that was like the tone throughout. We all cared a lot and wanted to try to deliver the best possible product.
Well, you all definitely did. Now, is it true that you really like to ride motorcycles in real life?
I do like to ride, yes.
Really? What kind?
I like the Harleys.
Oh, really?
I like the Harleys.
I thought you would be a crotch rock type of guy.
Nah, man, I love like this laid back, chill,
huh?
Relax.
I like Huffies.
Be able to do this.
Oh, stop it.
Huffies, there you go. You can pop Willies on the block.
Pop Willies, yeah.
We're <That's> awesome.
We're going to race.
I'm
going to get you on a Huffy.
I got
get
you.
A Harley.
I
what you going to get?
Huffy fast.
I'm going to get the katana.
You're going to crotch rock
it. Yes, sir.
Style.
Yes, sir.
No. All right. Now, very quickly, how do you go from this guy in South Central to becoming Mr. Sons of Anarchy and a TNT lead? I mean, how does that happen?
God.
Yeah, but incredibly. Like, walk us through that. I mean, clearly he's on your side, but what steps on the ground did you take to make that leap?
One of the first ones, I was in high school and I had a drama class in my fourth period as an elective that I did not select. And that teacher just pestered me. He was like, there's something special about you. You should do a play. You should do a play. So finally I just tried and I got on stage and I was bit by the proverbial bug. When I got on stage, I knew in my heart that's what I was supposed to do. Yeah. I just made the necessary sacrifices and things just aligned in a way, with studying and training and meeting the right people at the right times.
So when you get that first Oscar, make sure you thank that teacher for pushing you.
I know, I have to thank him. He's been incredible. He now works with Oprah and Tyler Perry, so we've crossed paths a couple of times in those circles.
Okay, in good company. We'll continue the great work that you're doing. Yeah. And we can check you out. A new season of Murder in the First premiering on TNT on June 8th. All right, thank you so much. We'll be right back.
Thanks for having me.
Yes, thank you.